Susan, Sophia, and Judit Polgár are all legends within the chess world. Each has achieved incredible amounts of success, and the youngest, Judit, was actually ranked at one point as one of the best chess players in the world, number 8, and she defeated 11 world chess champions. As we're going to find out in a little bit, they were actually the result of an educational experiment conducted by their father Laszlo in order to turn his children into geniuses. And given the fact that all three of them became either grandmasters or international masters, it appears that the experiment was a success. I'm Yona Paley, and I believe genealogy is fun. And on today's episode, we're going to be delving into the family of the Polgár sisters, probably the most famous chess family of all time. Zusa, aka Susan, Zofia, aka Sophia, and Judit Polgár were all born in the 1960s and 1970s. Their father, Laszlo, was a researcher and psychologist, and he wanted to test a very specific theory that he had, which is that geniuses are actually far more of a result of nurture than they are of nature. And he believed that if somebody from a very, very young age was taught to focus in on one or two subjects, in a very, very directed way, that they could become experts as long as they got started young enough. He and his wife Clara homeschooled the children, which was a very controversial thing to do back in the 1970s, and he chose chess as the main topic for them to focus on, but in addition he also taught them advanced skills like mathematics and the language of Esperanto. Now, as for Laszlo, he does have his own Wikipedia page, and this page does mention that he's from a city in Hungary called Jangyos, but that was pretty much all I was able to find about his past. That is, until I decided to use this trick that I've learned when trying to research people on Wikipedia. If you can find the article in the language of the person in question, oftentimes you'll be able to get more information than you would on an English Wikipedia page. So in this case, the page actually says that his parents were named Armin Protjovin and Serene Gelbman. And now we know a new fact, which is that the last name was not actually originally Polgár, it was Protjovin. A quick search through Jewish gen shows that a distant relative survived the Holocaust, and he actually gave a testimony to the USC Holocaust Foundation. And on this testimony, it lists both Armin Protjovin and Laszlo Polgár as being relatives. And from taking this, along with a lot of other Holocaust records, such as a page of testimony and some other little tidbits through Yad Vashem, that combined with some more articles in Hungarian translated on Google Translate, I was able to figure out that Armin's father was named Adolf Protjovin, and that, unfortunately, Adolf was murdered in the Holocaust. The records indicate that Adolf was married to a woman named Bluma Sarolta Rab, and that before living in Gyangyos, they actually came from a place called Hehalom. There are a number of burial records for Protjovins living in a place called Palota Shalom, which itself was a merge between Hehalom and another city, but it was eventually split back into Hehalom and its counterpart. Adolf was a textile manufacturer, and from looking at the page of testimony, I was able to take it back one further generation to Susan, Sophia, and Judith's great-great-grandfather, who was named Solomon Protjovin. And there is actually a death record available for a Solomon Protjovin on Jewish gen, but unfortunately, I'm not really sure if it's the same Solomon, but the record does indicate that he was from a town called Domoni, and from looking on Family Search through some records from Domoni, it does seem that there were Protjovins living there, but given the fact that this Solomon died in Budapest, I'm not really sure whether or not this is the same Solomon who is the father of Adolf, simply because of the fact that it doesn't reference the town that they were from or anything else that would clearly indicate that this is the relationship. But the good news is that Protyovin is not a super common surname, so it's quite possible that by doing a much deeper dive, maybe through some of the archives, maybe some stuff that's not available right now on the internet, that, you know, you could maybe take this family back a couple more generations and cement how the different Protyovins are related to each other. So there you have it, from a textile manufacturer to an experimental psychologist to three of the greatest chess players of all time, it's the Polgár family, formerly Protyovin, from Hungary. And that wraps up our episode. If you liked it, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. As always, I'm looking forward to bringing you more videos about famous Jews, as well as tips and tricks that you can use in your own genealogy research. So thank you so much for watching, and we'll get you next time.